listing objects in MinIO using Python. And in this video, we're going to be using Python 3.9. We're going to be listing our objects off of play.min.io, which is our online sandbox where anybody can work with the MinIO platform. And we're going to be running all of this out of Visual Studio Code. To dig in a little bit on what we're actually going to be showing you and what you'll be able to do at the end of this video, we're going to be looking at the list objects method, and the list objects method has a very simple list of variables it can take. We're going to examine a few of those, like including versions and recursion and things of that nature. And we're also going to be working with the response, which changes very slightly depending on the variables that you actually hand to list objects. Let's go ahead and take a look at some code. And here in our simple demo, we've got our import for MinIO, and I've also imported a MinIO demo functions. This is a collection of functions that allows me to hide some of the code that we're not really interested in. In this case, we're using it to call PlayConnect. This sets up the scaffolding, it creates a bucket, it uploads some files for me that I can then list. And then I'm also using it again to print the results. I'm going to take my list of objects, I'm going to print each one of them. And that rprint gives me a little formatting to what I'm actually printing out. So the key piece of code here, though, is our client list objects. This takes, at the very least, a bucket name. There are some other variables you can add. You can add in a prefix if you have prefixes set. You can do recursion or include versions. There's also a use API v1. List objects v1 S3 API is a little less performant. This, by default, is going to use v2. We suggest that you use v2 unless you have a compatibility issue. So we're going to go ahead and show you some of the work that we've got here. If I go ahead and run this code with Python 3, demo.py, I get back a couple of objects. Now, hello world text and image PNG, it says it doesn't have a version. Now, these are versioned because I've been uploading versions over and over and over again throughout all of these how-tos. So why is it not showing a version ID to me? Well, because I didn't ask it to include the version. In order to include the version, I need to ask it as such. I would go in here and I would say include version, and I would set this to true. Also, I could do, if I wanted to, I could do recursion here with a recursive, also takes a Boolean true. If I had prefixes, this would run through the prefix tree and give me all of them in there. There's also a start after. I can also include metadata. There's lots of different things that I can do here. But let's just do include version true and recursive true and see what the change is. So if I save this, run this one more time. Oh, well, there's our versions, and there's a lot of them. Look at all these. I've got 30 versions of image PNG and a similar number of versions of hello world.txt. And that way I can see all of the versions. Now, if I don't include version, I only get the last version. It gives me a none for the version ID, which is a little odd, but that's the way it is designed to work. So that is our demo for listing objects. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you'd like to reach out with us, you can use any of the methods that you see here on the screen. If you'd like to chat with us interactively, you can connect with us on Slack at minio.slack.com, or just leave a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.